In the lower ranges, the blocking is not necessarily complete, but in the higher ranges, it is so invariably.
Have you done this on any more subjects, Dr. Fabian?
Yes, 8 so far in a double-blind study, and the blocking effect was consistent.
Is a week of pre-treatment necessary in all cases?
No, sir.
We have already discovered that 2 days of pre-treatment suffices, and our guess is that it can be shortened even more.
Did you say this drug has clinical application?
Well, time will tell. But we've been quite impressed with our clinical results so far in some cases of acute schizophrenia, some cases of alcoholic hallucinosis, some senile hallucinatory states, and even a few cases of chronic schizophrenia. They represent about 60 cases in all. And furthermore, we are continuing our experimental work with hallucinogenic drugs, such as mescaline, cannabis, adrenochrome, etc. Are there any other questions?
Yes. Can MER-17 be used intravenously?
Yes, and it's very interesting, too. On December the 18th, 1954, Ronnie drank a second 100 gamma of LSD-25 without protection. 4.5 hours later, he was in an almost catatonic state. At that time, 10 milligrams of MER-17 was given intravenously and repeated in 15 minutes. This brought about a complete cessation and dissolution of his LSD-25 psychosis. Look at the picture.
I'm right here.
Do you feel that you're very close to us in your thinking?
No. No.
Can you tell me anything about what you have been thinking about? Is it too painful to talk about? Ron, how long does it seem to have been since you took the LSD?
I don't know. A couple of hours, I guess.
Are you upset?
No.
Are you muddled?
Yeah.
Can you tell me anything about your thinking now? Ron? Can you tell me anything about your thinking now?
I can't understand.
How do you feel?
Sorry.
Does anything make much sense to you now?
No.
What seems to be the matter?
Nothing.
Can you think?
No.
Can you tell me what's going on inside of your head? Ronnie, are you frightened? Are you fearful?
Yes.
Now, Ron, we're going to give you an injection to see whether it makes you feel any better. I don't suppose you taste anything, do you? Feel anything? All right. Now, about 3 minutes since you took the injection. What can you say about things now? Do things seem any clearer to you?
They do. I don't know why.
Can you elaborate on that in any way?
I'm just not as confused.
Now, Ron, it's been about 12 minutes since we gave you your injection. You just said that you feel like you have reality in your grasp and it's waxing and waning.
That's right.
Can you tell me anything more about it?
Maybe I said it's just a reorganization or a getting things in place again.
Is it a pleasant comeback, as it were, or is it disturbing to get things reorganized properly?
No, it's the more I can, the more it's the better I feel.
Okay, we're giving you a second injection about 17 minutes after the first one. How are you feeling now, Ron?
Like I'm waking up from a fever or something.
Is it a pleasant feeling to be waking up from a fever like this?
Well, pleasant to be back, I guess.
Bill, is there any change in his blood pressure?
No, his blood pressure and pulse remain essentially the same.
Why, it's been 30 minutes since we gave you the first injection and 15 minutes since we gave you the second one. Now, let's try to say how you feel now. I know it's hard.
Well, I haven't yet a foundation from which I can speak.
Do you think you feel differently than you did 30 minutes ago when you walked into this room?
Yes, I guess I do, very much so.
Now, Ronnie, it's been an hour since we gave you your first intravenous injection. I believe things have sort of come back into their proper perspective for you, haven't
they? I think so, yeah.
When you were under the LSD, you wanted to be in that room alone. You were fearful that there might be some sort of an invasion of your privacy, your integrity. Isn't that right? And now that's all cleared up, and you've got things straightened away. Is that right?
I'm no longer anxiety-ridden about it.
Mm-hmm. Are you your normal self now, do you think, Ron?
As nearly as I can tell, I am, yes.
You will probably be interested in my subjective reaction to this last experiment. The first and third experiments were similar, of course. Complete and insoluble confusion and anxiety reigned, and the knowledge that its cause was a drug was my sole and small reassurance. One hallucination was that of lying flat on a slowly revolving cloud-like object. There were other similar objects all around, touching gently and revolving in gear. I just rolled slowly down into the depths of this arrangement. Another one I recall is that of a flower bed type of pattern, or perhaps a purposeless pinball machine, with the lights arranged in rows and columns. The lights, or flowers, were growing, then bursting in irregular fashion, one at the left, then at the center, and so on. Next occurred the phenomenon that has happened both times I lost, and perhaps I've neglected to mention it previously. Things seemed to clear up, and I felt sane, yet I knew I wasn't. I seemed to wake up to a new world, the same situation, same people and environment, and yet everything, that is, my mental state, my life, had been altered. I was a stranger in this world. I could no longer speak to anyone as a person. And that was my state when I was given the shot, bewildered, confused, afraid to say a word till I could be sure of which world I was in. I realized that what happened to me in those few minutes after the injection has a tremendous significance. Because of this realization, I have worked it over often since then. But God help me, I can't tell you a thing. It just happened. There was no crescendo, no fitting together of the pieces, no breaking through the surface. All of a sudden, I found myself willing to cooperate, able to follow conversation more easily, just less anxiety-ridden. I don't know how or why. I'm sorry, but that's all I can report.